Well, as we know, STEM is just so critical for our whole workforce, and especially in the future. And if we want to really prepare our students, then we have to do something to upgrade, you know, what they're getting.
Because of the experience that I got with teaching, that changed my life. What I would like to do is work with STEM majors, biology, physics, chemistry, mathematics major, and eventually even with the engineering department.
I like the approach of identifying people who are in the sciences and who are excited about it, who then can be motivated enough to take education courses and learn how to share that with their students.
A lot of the roadblocks for people educationally are really almost self-imposed, of not believing they're capable of doing something. But given the opportunity, they can still learn the same things if it's presented the right way to them. And that's what we're hoping to do here. You know, open the world up for a lot of students who otherwise would be oblivious to it. And when that world opens up, it gives them a lot of opportunities for career paths.
I am super excited about this. This is like this is one of the things that I really wanted to do in my career. And when Mason gave this opportunity, it's like my dream coming true. I'm totally vested in this. I love it. I get goosebumps thinking about the project. In fact, one of my students already did a pilot this summer, and they taught the lesson plan she developed from a scratch, and then she implemented in the classroom. And see, she is a biology major. So I've already done a pilot study, but now, you know, I want to do it in a larger scale.
This program that Lamar is trying to develop right now, from what they can tell, there's really not another one in the country like it. As important as everybody agrees STEM education is, there's not any efforts being made to recruit the right kind of people. And so Lamar is really hoping that they can develop a prototype for people in other areas to use, where we can start developing the skills of the students that are needed for the future.
We're trying to expose these students with these STEM majors into a teaching profession development program over the summer, where they get exposed to, you know, lesson plan development, actually be in the classroom, teach what they have developed, and also expose them to teach live the software that Teacher Education Department has bought. So that will teach them the classroom management, and then where they can actually work one-on-one with Teacher Education faculty members and STEM department faculty members, where they actually learn how they can turn the content into pedagogical content knowledge. That means how they can be able to deliver the content into a teaching style into K-12 classroom.
Science majors will actually work in the classrooms with the students and get that experience of working with kids and helping turn on the light of excitement for the students at a young age. So the idea is finding students who are passionate about science and then getting them involved with education courses so that they then can bring that excitement to students.
I want us to have a lot of people who understand science, not necessarily that they're scientists, but understand how science affects us in our day-to-day life. Be able to think about things the way you approach things. The scientific method isn't to read how something is supposed to work, it's to look and see for yourself how things come together. I mentioned Dr. Russell Long, my favorite professor ever. He would give us tests that would teach us things, but he would always phrase it, "What did you see in the lab that explains how this works?" And then when I would fail the course, he would write, "I didn't ask you what the textbook said. I said, what did you see? What did you see in that microscope? What did you learn?" And I think I learned more in his classes than all my other teachers put together. It helped me as a businessman tremendously of really looking at things, trying to understand what was important about it. as a businessman, I get employees that are able to make decisions, that are able to react to changing environment, don't have to be told exactly what needs to be done, but can figure it out for themselves because they've done that before. So it's win-win in a lot of different directions.
I'm deeply touched by the generosity of people thinking that their effort along their life, you know, with what they earn, could make a difference for others, and in a way that it's not so much controlled directly by that person. Because that kind of generosity, which I would understand on my side, it's kind of you can control, but another thing is to give trust to others. So that's why I jump in a conversation like this quickly. It's because they have to see that their investment has a future. It's certainly going to work because there are people willing to prove they are worthy for the trust. You know, we have the chance, the blessing to receive from these generous donors.
I'm just very thankful for this opportunity. And I'm so looking forward to working towards it and making a positive impact, not only just the Lamar University, but Southeast Texas and beyond.